Hi there, this is Stacey the Dog Trainer, and today I'm going to be reviewing some of my favourite products that are on the market. And they all just happen to be in red for obvious reasons. I like red. We're going to be looking at the Comfy Clicker, which is by Dogs for the Disabled, the Walkie Dog with Love Harness, which is by Walkie Dog with Love. We're also going to be looking at this modified thing that we've done to the Walkie Dog with Love to make it more comfortable. Then we've got the Extra Dogs front leading harness. I think sometimes it's also referred to as the balance harness, which uses a T-touch effect. So we'll be looking at that. And then also the Indie Dog sliding lead. Now, the first product that I'm looking at is the Comfy Clicker. This was originally designed for disabled people, people that struggle to use their fingers, so as they could use it to in ways like this. They can sort of click it on the chair or on their clothes or, well, I'm fat so it doesn't really kind of work, but on yourself. I know you want a treat now, I'm really sorry, baby. I know. But I decided to pick one up whilst I was at Crufts anyway because it was only £4.50 and they're handmade by someone that actually works with them. They came up with the design, and it's almost like, let's see if I take it off. It's like a case that covers a clicker, and then it's got this sort of almost like bungee strap that you can use to pull it across over your hand. And even though it's for disabled people, I decided that it was kind of good for me because I'm always finding that when I'm using my clicker, I will either drop it by accident or end up with my hands full, and then I'm like, oh, for God's sake, my clicker's gonna like fall on the floor. Not anymore. I find that if I position it like that, then I can use even my little finger and still use all of my three main fingers whilst clicking and treating. I think it's a lot easier, and I'd really, really recommend one. And also, it's going to a good cause. It's going to help Dogs for the Disabled, which you can't really get any better than that. And it's not much more price than those that are in sort of large brand shops anyway, so it's like £4.50. I'd really recommend it. Right, now, first of all, we're going to look at the Walkie Dog with Love, the unmodified sort of version, which looks a bit like this. Okay, so this is the Walkie Dog with Love on a dog. The lead would attach to this front section here, and the harness is designed to lead the dog from the front, so as if they pull, you can lead them into a different direction. And it overall just stops the dog from pulling. Lou's looking really amused about this. The harness has had a really good successful rate with stopping dogs from pulling, and they're selling really, really well. I know that I'm selling a lot, and it's working out really well for a lot of people, but there is a major problem. Well, not really a major problem, but there is a problem. I am getting reports of dogs that are getting chafing underneath the front legs, but it only seems to really be happening with huskies. We don't really know why yet. It's something that we're trying to sort out. I've spoken to Walkie Dog with Love, and they are working on some improvements for the harness to make it more comfortable, including trying out different types of webbing, such as hello baby, padded webbing and things like that. There is one option that we've come up with temporarily, if you already have one or you want to use one pretty sharpishly, which I'll show you now. Okay, so what we have here is the Walkie Dog with Love, but we've added padding. This section here, it's just sort of like a tube of padding, which we got Indie Dog to produce for us. And it's really, really helping. It's really helping to stop the chafing. So I'd really, really recommend getting some of this tube from Indie Dog. It's not something that they generally have stuck on the website. But if you drop them an email, then they'll sort you out. Other than that, the harness is really good. So, I mean, I would recommend it with the padding as opposed to just normally. There is a video on YouTube of how it stops the pulling with two border collies, so feel free to go and check that out, or I'll pop a link in the description showing you how this one works. Okay, so now we have the extra dog front leading harness or balance harness, whichever you want to call it. It's got a little tiny O-ring on the front, and a little tiny O-ring on the back. This is the only harness which has permission to use an O-ring in this exact placing right here, as it's actually sort of a patent position for the O-ring by T-Touch, and the reason is because T-Touch is proven as an effective way to stop your dog from pulling. Ask Extra Dog for more information. I'm only just learning about it. So this harness works differently. Unlike the Walk Your Dog with Love, you don't just lead the dog from the front as such. You have to use both points of area, which is where a double-ended lead would come into the situation. Now, you can use it without a double-ended lead, and I will show you how to now. But the way that the harness works is that when you feel a point of pressure, like she's putting pressure there now, if I was using this properly, I would match the amount of pressure that she's giving on the front of the harness until she eventually sort of stopped, and then you let go of the pressure. Right, so this is, and she's not behaving silly, this is how you'd normally have the lead. You'd have a point attached at the front and a point attached at the back. Whenever she pulls from a particular area, I'd apply pressure. So normally you'd use two hands. So I applied pressure then at the front, and it was only to match the same pressure as her. And the second that she let that pressure go, I released the tension. And that's how this harness works. See, she's doing it again, so I'm just going to... See what I mean? It goes based on T-Touch. And that's just sort of calming down, which is how T-Touch works. You'd use, obviously, two hands normally. You'd have one hand sort of holding the front, and you'd have one sort of holding the back. If I had another hand, it would be there, and this hand would be here. And I'd just be walking and carefully matching the pressure. There's none of this tugging to the side type thing. It's just literally slightly matching the pressure. And that's how this harness works. The reason why I like this one is, one, it's using T-Touch methods, which is being proven to help dogs that are in need of stress, anxiety, and other issues. But also, it's really comfy. It's really well padded. And even down to where sort of the clips are, they recommend that you put a stitch here to stop the padding from swiveling round, because the reason why it's like that is so you can adjust the harness. That's why it's loose. But if you apply a stitch there, once you've got the correct fitting on your dog, then you're kind of sorted. So, yeah, that's kind of how this one works. it's difficult to show you when you've only got one set of hands. But like I did with the Walk Your Dog with Love one, I will do a video where you can see the difference between a collar and using this harness. But, yeah, these ones are more expensive than Walk Your Dog with Love ones. But they're kind of worth it, if that makes sense. So what I've actually done here is I'm not using a double-ended lead. I'm using the Indie Dog slider lead. And I've sort of wrapped that through around there and then used a clip at the front, because I'm lazy and like to use multiple products. And now we're looking at the Indie Dog slider lead. One note though, I have had an addition added. I have had an O-ring added just there, which I'm sure is an option that they could sort you out with if you wanted one. The reason why I've done that is because I also like the addition of being able to clip that round like that and then having my flexi lead on there, so as if it got pulled out of my hands, I'd still have the dog attached to me with this over my shoulder, almost like a police lead. Right, so ignoring that addition, because that's something I've had added, the lead comes with sort of your standard clip at the front here. You've got a section, a handle here, for a traffic handle, for if you go near the traffic or you need more control over your dog. And then you've got this metal slider here, which is a million times better than plastic ones, because it is, well, it's not going to break, is it? And then you've got like this loop. And the good thing about it is you can use it in lots of different ways. You can use it to put over your shoulder. You can use it to tighten to your waist.
Right. If you can see this. One way of using it is going over the body and then sliding, adjusting to my waist. And then I have a point of connection then for the dog, so it's almost like a walking belt. Obviously it's not going to be it's padded. I don't know if you can see the sun goes, do like a crouch swap. yeah, and then you can attach the dog from the front there. That's one way you can use it. Or let's slide this out. You can go over the shoulder, clip to harness or to the collar, however way you want to do it. As I said, you've got the control handle, so as if you had the dog there, you've got more control. What ways can we use this? Let me think now. There are plenty of ways you can use this. You can use it to loop around something, so as you can tie the dog to something, so as you've got them in a safe place whilst you go to like the toilet or something. You can adjust the length of it. I've got a little handle there now, and all of a sudden the lead's a lot longer, which is kind of handy for training. There's loads of fabulous uses with this.
So that's all of the products that I'm looking at today, and I hope that's given you something to think about, or at least you've learned something. So, yeah, this has been Stacey the Dog Trainer and Aloo the Siberian Husky, and we'll speak to you soon. Bye!